set you on?
I'm about to be on my last set real quick.
Well, you need to pick up the pace. I need to go to lunch. Shoot. He's taking his time. Well, since he's still in the gym, and the gym taking forever doing his workout, shoot, I guess I might as well come talk to y'all for a second. Turn it down! Okay, actually, no, don't turn it down. I like that song. I like that song a lot. That they don't play. It's one of my warm-up songs. Why you turn it down?
You said turn it down.
I said don't turn it down. I said turn it down, but don't turn it down. You don't be listening. Just like y'all. Y'all don't be listening. All right, so check this out real fast. So I'm sitting here in the office, you know, getting ready to do Ray's Take this evening, whatever. First of all, I appreciate all y'all for being on this channel. Y'all have also made it very hard for me to do my job. I'm telling you. So the videos I put up, of course, from the Jamaican trials, flagged, had to take them down. It's like the channel has gotten so big in track and field to where it's like people I don't know. I just can't do what I used to do no more. So we got to find another workaround. And we did the copyright claim and stuff too. Even we do that, it's just like, nah, you're too big. So we're going to figure it out because I got to figure out a way. I got to get back with the real Brayo. We got to figure something out, baby, because I need to be able to show y'all these videos and break them down at the same time while I'm showing them to y'all. But real fast, let's do a quick recap of what happened this weekend. If you notice my title, you saw my title. I think we in trouble. Here's why I think we in trouble, okay? Hear me out. When this show first started, the reason why this show first started was because all y'all, every last one of y'all, I ain't say every last one of y'all. When I sat there and said that Shakira's time was questionable because of the track. The track was a stupid, super fast track. But I even said then, but she's capable by the time we get to USA Nationals of hitting 10-6 or possibly 10-5. Because I said that track surface, when they build it, is going to give it to her, no matter what. And I said she's fast, okay? I went on record many of times saying that, you know, back in my younger heyday, we knew what tracks to go looking for to get our damn time at. It's no secret the reason why half the people that was at the trials was there because they got their times at Miramar. Let's just call it what it is. And it's not hating, it's understanding the game. It's just like tennis. Anybody that play tennis will tell you. Clay courts versus grass courts. Complete different surfaces gonna give you different type of speeds. Same thing with football. A football player will tell you, grass versus turf is gonna give you different type of speeds. I don't understand why y'all think track and field don't do the same thing, but whatever. So this Oregon surface, I've talked to people out there. I mean, I had athletes that I work with that's running on it. Okay, my correspondent's got it. You guys know Manuel, he's out there. Unanimously across the board, everybody has told me, Ray, I've never touched the surface that feels the way this surface feels. I've heard people say, bro, I shot off for 20 meters. It took me 40 meters to slow down. I've heard people who are coaches out there just running on it just for a workout because they got on the track and was like, bro, this is the fastest track I've ever touched in my life. So it leads me to this. We witnessed at the USA trials a slew of higher. I mean, they was chopping them up. Records was going down left and right. Didn't matter if it was a world record, stadium record, Olympic record, fastest this in history, fastest that in history. Did not matter. You know what they were doing? They was taking them and they was. I wish I had a piece of paper. I'll show you. Matter of fact, I do got. This is what they was doing. This is USA trials. Right? 400 hurdles, cha cha cha. 200, cha cha cha. Fast 1800 personnel. 100, cha cha cha. Shutting down their rounds. What else we had out there? 1980, everybody shattering. Fastest finals ever in history. Hey, oh, I forgot. 800 meter girl. She damn near failed and still broke records. If she hadn't failed, she'd have shattered the record. So here's the point I'm trying to get to y'all. This weekend, down in down yonder in the Yam territory, in the Yam land, as we call it, Jamaica. They had their trials too. They girls ran just as fast as our girls. I told you that in the last video. They girls ran just as fast as our girls did. Now, the problem is, Jamaica's surface is also fast. But from what they're telling me, it's not Oregon fast. It's a slower surface. So on a slower surface, they're producing faster times than our girls are in the hundreds. On a slower surface, and in the morning time, they're running just as fast as our girls in the 200, not on the same surface. So y'all know how I do this show. You know how I analyze stuff. That's why I do. All I do is analyze stuff. So what you want me to believe is, if Jamaica had had their trials, their nationals, in Oregon instead of in Jamaica, would have seen all type of records shattered. Got broken, shattered. Again, my job is to analyze stuff. My job is to look at everything in the light that nobody wants to look at it in. So what you telling me is, the Jamaican girls had ran in Oregon, they would have been shattering records? I mean, based off the track surface is what everybody telling me now. So did we dig ourselves in a hole for embarrassment? Is my real question. And what I mean by we, I mean Team USA. Well, at least on the girls' sides. The boys ain't no other men running fast except for the South African kids. And so we're not gonna discuss that right now. We're only discussing USA female versus USA Jamaica. USA females versus Jamaican females. Did we shoot ourselves in the foot and set us up for failure? And what I mean by that is, come on, y'all. Much respect, much props to everybody out there. The way I look at it is, time don't matter. A W is a damn W. If you cross the line first, Jack, you won. That's all that matters. You are Olympic trials champion. Congratulations. You are the best there is to do it. If you finish in the top three, damn a time, you are the best three in the world or in America at that point in time. Jack, much respect to you for that. That shows a whole lot. That means I am great. So I would not take the greatness away from any athlete at American Trials, because no matter what, you had to train for that and you had to go beat everybody else out there on that same track. So I'm not taking that greatness away from them. What I am concerned about is, come on, y'all. Those records and a lot of those top four or five, whatever in history, was only possible because of the track. So if it's only possible because of the track, what are we leading our people into? Because now it's like, okay, well, if I don't have this same surface, will I still produce that time? Chances are you probably won't. Okay, well, if I don't have that same surface and I got to go face the people who ran faster than me without that surface, how can I beat them? I'm asking that question again. Make sure y'all got it. If I ran fast on what would be arguably called the fastest surface ever created, and my competition, the team I'm going against, they ran faster than me or just as fast as me on a surface that's not as fast as the surface I did mine on. So what's going to happen when we line up next to them on a fair surface? And by fair surface, I mean on a neutral surface. What's going to happen when we get to Tokyo? Because that's a neutral surface. Granted, Tokyo is going to be probably just as fast or probably faster than Oregon's track. I mean, because keep in mind, Shanghai is in Tokyo. Shanghai by far is one of the fastest tracks that's still surviving right now. Think about what all happens in Shanghai, the American records and all that stuff. All those fast times come from Shanghai. So Tokyo is about to build a Shanghai times two. And Tokyo is not going to let America outdo them when it comes to building anything. So this track surface, this arena that people about to walk into in Tokyo is about to be state of the art. Trust me, it's about to be something ridiculous. So you're still going to get fast times. But if we take times and put them all in the pot together, based on what we've seen this weekend, and we only got roughly four before Tokyo starts. Team Jamaica is not finna stop training between now and then. Team America is not finna stop training between now and then. I feel confident that in some aspects, some areas, that they won't mess with Team America at all. You know, like the hurdles, give it up. That's on lock. I'm only really talking about the sprints, the 200s and the 100s. The showdown. The showdown is finna go down in Tokyo down. Right now, me being who I am, what I do, self-proclaimed analyst of track and field, I would have to say that at this particular time, at this particular point, after everything I've seen over this weekend, you can argue with me all day long. That's why I have this show, damn it. You can disagree with me all day long. I don't give a damn. Based on everything I've seen this weekend, on the female side, wow. Based on everything I've seen this weekend on the female side, y'all think it's going to be hard for the U.S. to get a medal in 200? Shashaka, however you want to call her, she not playing. She really not playing at all. And they make it look so easy. That's the problem. Like, our girls are working for those times and getting them. They damn near right next to them, making it look easy. Shedeka's coming at 200. You better believe it, Jack. On Oregon surface, she probably would have ran 21.5, 21.6. And she got second to Shelly Ann. Shelly Ann had a ridiculous curve. Nobody's going to mess with her on that curve. She probably would have went like 21.5 in Oregon as well. Elaine has an injury still. And Elaine's able to keep up. Which means if Elaine gets it right, like her foot and Achilles in the next month, she's going to be back in contention. It's not like she's out of contention now, but she's going to be really back in contention. Brings me to be concerned, guys. I'm concerned. All right, brother. Tomorrow morning, 11 a.m.
11, got it.
Like I was saying, it's bringing me to my concern. Again, all I do is analyze stuff, y'all. Y'all know me. It's all I do. It's, you know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing, you know. It's just me just sitting back, like, putting everything in the pot, like I always tell y'all to do. Put everything into the pot. Let it all marinate. And if I let it all marinate, I'm going to put my disclaimer out there on this. I am definitely 1,000%, 1,000% pulling for Team USA. I was born here. You know, I'm Team USA, Team Nigeria. So, you know, I'm going to pull for Blessing at the same time, but I'm going to pull for the home team, man. I got to. So, but just because I got to pull for the home team, again, as an analyst, don't mean I got to be stupid. It don't look good for the home team. It don't. It don't look good for the home team at all. I think that we're walking into an arena. We're walking into a fight that even us giving our all, if that's what you want to call it, even our all ain't good enough. Y'all, I can only call it like I see it. I can only call it like I see it. Right now, I got to call it the way I'm calling it based off of that track surface. People, let me explain something to you. There's no way in the dimension of the universe that we live in, there's no way that that many human beings could be physically fit to perfection on the exact same day. And what I mean by that is, you cannot have that many people breaking records at the same time. It's literally impossible. It's impossible because different training regimens. Now, I know what everybody's gonna say, well, Ray, they train to peak at the right time. These are facts. They do. They do. But peaking and breaking records or running second and third fastest times in history is literally impossible for over an array of events for that to happen, from hundreds to 200s to 400s and 400 hurdles. And I mean, we go all the way back to NCs. The boy ran 43 NCs. 10 flats and stuff in NCs. Girls in NCs are dropping 10 sevens. But what's the, just this past weekend? Y'all, it is impossible. It is literally impossible for that many people to be at the record-breaking performance in their life, in their game, at the exact same time. Now, if everybody came from the same camp, cool. If everybody all lived and trained in Oregon, cool. But you got people coming from all different areas with all different type of coaches, all different type of training. Yes, everybody was trained to be ready at the trials. But there's no way for everybody to be ready to break a record or become second, third, fourth, fastest anything in history at the exact same time, Jack. It has to be the surface now. The surface says, if you're ready, I'm going to give you some more. Now, the problem with also with that is, You're putting people on pedestals that they can't stay on. Stay with me. If my PR now is 21.6, go with like Gavin. And I'm not saying any of these people's contracts are structured this way. I'm just basing off of what I've known, how reductions go. Or time bonuses go. If I went to Oregon and I don't win third, fourth fastest time in history or whatever, and that's now my PR, guess what I can't do no more for the rest of my career? Until I come back to Oregon, I can't hit that time no more. Guess what I cannot do? I can't really stay in the top five or top 10 because when I have to go race other people from other countries who are just as fast as me, or if not faster, I will no longer be up here. So what does this do? What happens when you got athletes that are walking into like Tokyo and they got the world record in this, second fastest in history in this, third fastest history in that, all the way down to whatever you want to call it in history and all these records, and then they go to Tokyo and get beat? I'm not saying they're going to get beat. I'm just, again, doing my job as an analyst, just looking at everything and making my decision based off that. What is going to happen when you got all these people who just did all this outstanding, amazing stuff this weekend that's going down in history? History was made at Hayward Field this weekend. Chances are that most of the people that made history, well, again, I'm just going to say it like on the sprint side of things. Y'all can leave that 400-meter hurdle alone. Y'all ain't touching that. That 400-meter hurdle, that's American. Flat, Jack, don't even line up. I can tell you that now. I don't give a damn what the clock say. I don't give a damn about what the record. Y'all can just not line up for that at all. I'm really still talking about 200 and 100. What's going to happen when you go over there and the possibility of losing happens? based off my analogy, based off of what I'm saying, based off of me saying surface versus surface, time versus time, common sense says, if I can run the same time that you ran on your fast surface on the slower surface, what gonna happen when we get on the same surface, Jack? If I can run just as fast as you on a slower surface and you on a super fast surface, scratch that. You're on the fastest surface ever and I'm still running faster than you on a slower surface. What's that gonna say when we line up next to each other? Yeah, I think we got a problem. We got a serious problem. The problem is, at some point in time in track and field, we gotta stop worrying about time. Time gotta go out the goddamn window. Because the way they playing with times now, the way they playing with clocks, I mean, you had Great Britain, she had 10.7 and that jumped to 10.9. You had Blessing go 10.6 and it came down. You had Shelly Ann clock in the beginning, and, you know, and now you got the Oregon tracks. At some point in time, we got to just throw time out of the damn picture and say, you know what, Jack? It's childhood again, Jack. Ain't no damn clock, Jack. We going light pole to light pole. Damn a time, damn with all that shit. We ain't doing it no more. Beat me. That's what we got to start back doing. We got to get to that track and field. We got to get to the track and field to where every surface is the same. We got to get a track and field to where it's a standard surface for professional athletes. Basketball courts ain't shorter. They're all the same. High school basketball court ain't the same as a pro basketball court. Football fields in college and pros ain't the same. And when you get in pro, it's standard. Everybody got to have the same damn thing. Damn them, okay? You can't have 40 city lines and somebody got 45. Y'all know what I'm trying to say. What I'm trying to say is, until we can legitimately, as a professional athlete, you know, professional sport, make the playing fields even, it ain't gonna be fair. It might even, I mean, even with the drug testing. The drug testing protocols ain't fair. They're not fair at all. Because everybody got their own drug testing protocol. How the hell is Jamaica gonna have one protocol? America gonna have one protocol? Great Britain gonna have one protocol? You got doggone China gonna have one protocol? How are y'all gonna have all different protocols for drug testing, but all y'all gotta race at the same track meet at one time? That don't work. That don't work. That ain't gonna work. How the hell y'all got fast services in certain places, slow services in certain places, and you got other athletes looking crazy? Because you got athletes going to these fast services and dropping stupid times. You got other athletes like, how, Sway? I just beat them last week. How do you run that damn? Too much confusion. Well, everything I'm saying in this video is going to show face when we get to Tokyo. Watch what happens in Tokyo. Everything in the video that I'm saying is going to show face. We got to fix this shit some kind of way. We have to fix this. Because it's not right. It's not real. This is how I started this show. This show started because I was explaining to people how these times aren't real. They're not real. The athletes are real. The amount of training they're putting in to what they're doing is real. Going from start line to finish is real. But when you sit here with these souped up surfaces, these extra souped up spikes and all this other stuff, and it's not level, that's unfair to the actual athlete now. That can mess your psyche up. Like, if you go to one place and you drop, well, I'll take that back. It won't really mess your psyche up because athletes know. We all know, like, man, it's the only reason I ran fast because of that track. So I'll take that back. It won't mess the athlete's psyche up. It does get aggravating, though, from the fan base when the fans are like, well, how are you running? Why is she running like that now? Why are you running like that now? He just dropped this. He just dropped that. That's why. Services ain't the same. So I'm going to end this long video up by saying I'm scared for Tokyo. I'm very scared for Tokyo, actually, because I think there's going to be some hearts broken in Tokyo. I think there's going to be some people going into Tokyo with expectations that may not be met. I think some people are going to lose and they thought they was going to win. And I think it's all been set up unfairly based off of that track. They shouldn't have did that. They shouldn't have made that track that fast because it's not that fair. They shouldn't have did that. That's all I got to say. That track shouldn't be that fast. If that track's going to be that fast, every track should be that fast. But then again, if every track was that fast, if Jamaica had a track like that, what the hell would happen to day trials? Damn. I don't know what to say no damn. I'm going to lunch.